Welcome back to Vegication. We are talking about your best day. We've given you breakfast, we've given you midday and lunch, and now we're gonna wind it down and finish
and
off.
And not eat for dinner.
No, we're gonna eat for dinner, but that's just true. Like a little bit. A little bit for dinner.
Which is not what anyone does, by the way.
No, but we do it wrong. Speaking of doing it wrong, mm-hmm. I saw online that like everybody uses trash bags wrong. This is not at all related to what we're talking about.
Oh, trust me, I already got educated. My husband made me turn it inside out.
Good job, Gerald.
Yes.
Yes. So we're going to, like the trash bags, we're going to teach you how to do dinner correctly, which is smaller portion. Mm-hmm. And then also, dinner should be, I used to make fun of people for like eating dinner early, but turns out they were right. I'm wrong. You need to have a lot of time in between your last meal and when you go to bed, right?
As far as, again, if you're just trying to get calories in and, you know, if let's say you were counting your macros, does it really matter when you eat? No. Do I find that I sleep better when I eat earlier? Yes, because your body has to work all night to digest that food. Some people may be able to go to bed on a bucket of fried chicken and mashed potatoes from Kentucky Fried Chicken.
But Kentucky.
Kentucky. I don't know where my accent comes from.
I don't know either.
It just comes
You're
out
You're not
sometimes.
Southern.
I'm not, but sometimes I sound
Sometimes
it.
You are.
I don't know. But I could not do that. I don't feel my best when I go to bed on a really full stomach.
And I'm the opposite. I like to snack late in the day. I like to have my dinner and then like a little nosh.
What's a little nosh consist of? Tell me.
You know, it might be like a granola bar, might be like some ice cream.
So sugar.
Yes. I have a problem, Leia. Please stop judging me.
She does have a
problem. I can't control my sugar.
So I may
be wants what it
one
wants.
Of the world's best coaches, but I'm failing my best friend.
We're going to work on my sugar. We're going to change my taste buds. I know it.
Yes.
It's not impossible.
So what about nighttime routine?
Nighttime routine. So I like what you said about starting your day not looking at your phone. I actually don't look at my phone at night. So when people call me at like 8:30,
guilty.
I wonder why I don't answer my phone. It's because it's over there.
Which is good because your phone light can keep you up at night.
Yeah.
So I always aim to try and put mine away an hour. What I do is I just let it die. So then there's no way I can turn it back on because I do a lot of business on social media, you know, talking
You're on
to
your
people.
Phone a lot.
I'm on my phone a lot.
Yeah.
And so because of that, I try and let it die. Then I go plug it in my room. The alarm's already set and I don't look at it again until the morning.
So you mentioned the lights, like how your body kind of like winds down if there's a lot of, is it ambient light? Like what comes from the phone and comes from the TV, is that what it's called?
Yeah, so there's the red light blockers and the blue light blockers. Blue light blockers obviously are going to be the ones that you're gonna wear at night.
What is a blue light blocker? Is it like a mask?
Yeah, so there's evidence to show that it can block out that bad light from your phone that disrupts your sleep and keeps you up all night.
Okay, so it's different than a regular face mask because I do enjoy those. Like a blackout, like just I don't want to see anything. I don't want to see anybody. Like just let me sleep.
These are glasses.
Yes. Oh, you sleep in glasses.
You don't sleep in them. No, it's just you're wearing them leading up to bed. If you want to sleep in glasses, Britt, though, go ahead.
So I like that. You can wear the glasses like leading into your bedtime routine.
Yep.
And then you take those off. You throw on your sleep mask like me and then you just REM sleep all night long.
Yeah. And again, you know, one of the big things is if you can't get to sleep, try doing sleep meditations. Try doing, bedtime meditations, things that will get you into that mode. I know last night when I flew in, right, it was 10 o'clock my time. I was wired, did not want to go to sleep. So I definitely turned on a sleep bedtime story meditation. It did help.
Do you have a preference of what you use, like a YouTube series or anything like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, I love Calm. Calm has the most bedtime stories, and you kind of feel like a kid again. You know, Jay and I will play them, and it'll be like all these different stories. And last night I was listening, I don't know, it was one about the south of France, and it was very fancy.
This is what you listen to put yourself to sleep?
Well, last night I did. Sometimes it's about a teddy bear and his birthday. It just
so
really,
random.
Really depends. Yes.
So we talked about having breakfast be a big meal, mm-hmm. having lunch be a big meal, mm-hmm. and then having dinner be kind of small.
Yep.
So what is one of your like go-to dinner recipes?
Well, now that it's cold again, I am soup.
I love soup.
Soup, soup, and more soup.
Yeah.
Soup is easily digestible. I love a good lentil soup. The vegan eight is probably my favorite website of all of them. Most of her recipes are 8 ingredients or less, so that is theveganno8.com. And most of her recipes are going to be oil-free.
I love it.
Just very simple, super flavorful. You know, you can have a little piece of bread with it if you would like, if you need something.
A little piece of bread, like a crouton?
Or if you're my husband, you can have a whole baguette of bread. No one's here to judge you. But yeah, just, you know, I always say start with a hearty bowl. If you feel a little hungry after 20 minutes, then have another bowl.
You know, I do that with my kids. When I give them a portion and then they say, well, I want more, I make them wait.
Yeah.
I make them wait, even if it's like 5 minutes. I'm like, let your food digest just for 5 minutes. I'm gonna come back. If you're still hungry, I will happily give you more. Mm-hmm. 9 times out of 10, they're fine.
Yeah, and that's the thing. A lot of people do not give their body time to digest that food and get it down there. And that's another reason I don't recommend drinking water while you eat, or really drinking anything while you eat, because it messes with that digestion and your ability to be able to feel, am I really full? And so many people have lost that because we've all been on diets for so long. So we're either binging or we're restricting. Mm. And so we don't really know how that hunger cue even happens.
I know I don't.
You don't feel it?
No, I feel like I'm either super, super hungry or I can't eat because I'm just not hungry at all. I don't have an in-between, but I have started putting into practice, like when I'm actively eating and I finish my portion, I wait to see if I'm hungry. Like I do the same thing I do with my kids. Mm-hmm. And that has helped because, like I said, a lot of times turns out I wasn't hungry. I just wasn't finished eating what I had already eaten.
Right. And so again, it's slowing down enough to get back to listen to those hunger cues. Are you eating in front of the TV every night? That's going to mess with your body's ability to be able to say, I'm full, because you're having that stimulation on the television or the stimulation on your phone. So get back to the table and slow down. Chew your food.
Yeah.
I mean, if that's one thing I can tell you today, chew your food. Try even just doing it 15 times before you swallow.
It's just going to be water at that point. Like, that's a lot of chewing.
It's going to be mush. But if you think about a piece of broccoli, right? So think about it as you're putting it in your mouth. It's this huge thing. How's that going to work? Like, how hard, if you chew it 3 times, is that not helping?
Well, I take tiny bites. I like to cut my food up real small, like a gerbil.
A gerbil?
Yeah, just like real tiny, little dainty bites.
I don't know why that equates to a gerbil. But I'm just going to let you run with
that. They're tiny animals. They eat small bites. I don't know.
Well, again, we're not going to do the research on that. We'll let you guys do that for yourself. But we're going to be right back in a minute. Thank you so much.